could go. An invitation was made to Sting. And now we'll find out what is the White Castle of Fear at Super Brawl. Two of the greatest tag teams collide. Ricky Steamboat and Shane Douglas against Flying Brian and Stunning Steve Austin. WCW Worldwide Wrestling's on the air. It's Tony Schiavone along with Jesse the Body Ventura. And what a main event. Ricky Steamboat and Shane Douglas, the World Tag Team Champions against Flying Brian and Stunning Steve Austin.
I'll tell you, Tony, it was a bloodbath at the Clash, and we got it right here on Worldwide this week.
We're going to be seeing the match a little bit later on, right after their tremendous matchup at Clash of the Champions. I had a chance to talk to Ricky Steamboat and Shane Douglas, and here's what they had to say. This is Tony Schiavone coming to you from Milwaukee, and what a battle it was for the Unified World Tag Team Championship. Gentlemen, you're still the champs, but it was quite a war.
You know something, Tony Schiavone? The announcers, wrestling editors, and magazines, they kept saying that Shane Douglas was the weakest link in this tag team combination. They kept saying that this tag team is not vicious enough. Well, it all started with this. The gold, the World Heavyweight Championship. Tag team, unified. You can't get any higher than this. Yes, a war has just been started.
A war?
And you know...
A war? If this is a war, we'll fly on Brian and Stunning Steve. You drew first blood. My dad always said, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. You gentlemen decided to start the war and you drew first blood. You can make darn sure and place the bet. We are happy to finish it anytime, any place you gentlemen want.
That's it for the World Tag Team Champions here in Milwaukee. Certainly the Tag Team Champions are not worried about the belts. They just want Austin and Pillman.
I'll tell you, Rush Limbaugh never looked better.
Fans, let's go to the ring. Our very first event coming up this week on WCW Worldwide Wrestling.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Tampa, Florida, weighing 250 pounds, Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff.
Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff. In our first event this week on Worldwide Wrestling, one of the premier athletes ever to step into the ring, and what a way to start out Worldwide as we go back to Gary Capetta.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent, he's from Minneapolis, Minnesota. He weighs 241 pounds, the Z-Man.
All right, the Z-Man, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. There you see the sign. Z-Man has a tremendous following of fans. Nick Patrick, the referee, assigned to our first event this week here on Worldwide, Jess.
Yeah, that's all fine and dandy, but Mr. Wonderful could care less what kind of following of fans the Z-Man has. Mr. Wonderful's the type of wrestler, he don't need fan approval.
Legendary athlete, and certainly he needs to be concerned about one Cactus Jack as well. Collar and elbow tie up, both men, tremendous upper body development. Into a corner now. Calling for the break. Right hand that time on the break by Z-Man, and a warning there to both athletes from Nick Patrick.
And another collared elbow hook up Z-Man with a headlock back into a hammerlock. Nice move there. Let's see how Wonderful tries to counter this one.
Orndorff trying to escape into a fireman's carry takeover. Great maneuver. Z-Man comes right up with the arm one more time, though. Both men back up to the vertical base. Shoulder block takedown. And Orndorff over the top to the near side. Feels him out from the near side. Drop kick. And a drop toe hold takedown. He goes right to the arm one more time.
And very good wrestling right here by the Z-Man. He's getting a slight upper hand on Mr. Wonderful. But you know, a wily veteran like Wonderful, he needs a little time to warm up. But I'm sure he'll get it clicking on all cylinders pretty soon.
Z-Man hits chest first. Orndorff a belly to back out of the turnbuckle, and a tremendous move by Orndorff. Great execution. He stomps away on the head again.
And you saw Z-Man's skull crack that mat in Wonderful, wasting no time. Drives a couple boots into his head. Now grabs him by the hair and introduces the pretty boy's face to the mat.
Clothesline off of the far side, and now Orndorff with a high risk maneuver now. Top turnbuckle.
Wonderful giving the sign. You know what that means. If he hooks the pile driver, it's over.
Picks up Z-Man. Pile driver. He got it.
Here you see Mr. Wonderful going up to the top, coming down with a big elbow smash right in the shoulder blades of the Z-Man. Sets him up for the patented call. Mr. Wonderful, Orndorff pile driver, knocks the Z-Man cold. 1, 2, 3. Big victory for Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff. Now, let's go to my colleague, Tony Schiavone, who's standing by with the new U.S. Heavyweight Champion, Dustin Rhodes.
Thank you very much, Jesse. Congratulations, Dustin, new U.S. Heavyweight Champion. I know it's a big moment in your career.
Yeah, so many great champions have held this prestigious United States Heavyweight title. And I'm very honored to be holding the new, to be the new United States Heavyweight Champion. And I'm ready for any challenge. But one thing is on my mind, and that's you, Barry Windham. Barry Windham, in any given arena around the United States or around the world for that matter, I'm going to step in the ring with you and finish exactly what you started.
Dustin Rhodes, the new U.S. Heavyweight Champion. More action still to come right after WCW Magazine.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to the WCW Magazine. Later on in the broadcast, Jim Ross will be along in the Super Brawl 3 Control Center. We're going to find out the details on the Vader-Sting match. We do know that the Great Muta, the new NWA champion, will defend his title against Barry Windham at Super Brawl 3. But I want to take you back now to Tokyo. 67,000 people on hand as the Great Muta challenged Masahiro Chono for the NWA title. Take a look at this. The record-breaking crowd came to the Tokyo Egg Dome to see two of their favorite gladiators. The champion Masahiro Chono defend his title against one of the most popular athletes in the Orient, the Great Muta. At one point in the contest, Muta took a running clothesline at the champion. Chono hit the deck hard, but in the end, it was the devastating moonsault off the top turnbuckle that captured the coveted NWA title for the Great Muta. The high-flying aerial attack of the Great Muta, the NWA champion, taking on the challenge of the hard-hitting Barry Windham, and it's coming your way at Super Brawl 3. You're also going to see the Smoky Mountain Tag Team Champions, the Rock and Roll Express, step into the ring with the Wrecking Crew. Tag Team action coming your way February 21st, only on pay-per-view. Contact your local cable company and order Super Brawl 3. I'm Eric Bischoff. We'll be back with more hard-hitting action and the Super Brawl 3 Control Center later on in the broadcast.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied by seven-time former World Heavyweight Champion, Harley Race. He's from the Rocky Mountains. He weighs 450 pounds. The WCW World Heavyweight Champion, Big Van Vader. Ladies and gentlemen, his opponent from Indianapolis, Indiana, 230 pounds, Bobby Baker.
The world champion, Van Vader, against Bobby Baker. In this event on Worldwide, maybe the most impressive entrance in all of sports to see that big guy come through the curtains.
I'll tell you what, Schiavone, I don't envy Bobby Baker right now at all.
Vader,
you know, I think I'd rather be you than Bobby Baker right now, if you can imagine how strongly I feel about that.
Well, I can imagine anybody wanting to be anything but the man in the ring against Big Van Vader, who's made an invitation to Sting to enter the White Castle of Fear. I do understand we will have more on it later on in the hour, but Vader is just an intimidating force in the sport. Look at this. At 450 pounds, just manhandling Baker from the beginning. And those forearm shots, they're awesome.
Oh, look at that. And he is exactly what he is. He is the World Heavyweight Champion. He right now is the best that there is. There are none better. It's that simple. And don't forget his mentor outside the ring, seven-time World Heavyweight Champion Harley Race.
Picks up Baker. Look at this. Like a human torture rack. What is he going to do? Oh!
That's what I love about Big Van Vader. He knows how powerful he is. Oh, look at that. Get ready. Powerbomb. Oh.
The powerbomb. 1, 2, it's over.
WCW World Heavyweight Champion, Big Ben Beaver.
Jesse, you were right about how easy it is for Big Ben Beaver to secure a win. Now, fans, Jesse making his way for a special interview here in just a few moments. But right now, take a look at this crucifix. All the way falling backwards, and then the awesome powerbomb. Sting told me in an interview, he said, when you're putting the powerbomb, regardless of who you are, you're going to go out. Your winner, Big Van Vader. Jesse Ventura now standing by with Barry Windham.
Barry Windham, first of all, let me say I want to shake your hand. You are the consummate professional athlete today. Second of all, I know there's two dudes out there with titles that you're looking at real hard. One, your former partner, Dustin Rhodes, and two, the newly crowned NWA champion, the great Muda.
Well, Jesse, I heard Dustin Rhodes out here mouthing off not too long ago about how he's the new United States heavyweight champion. Well, if he ever gets in a ring with me with that championship around his waist, it'll be really short-lived because it'll be mine. And the other guy, Muda, who holds the NWA heavyweight championship. Muda, that's something that I've been destined for a very long time. And when I step into the ring with you at Super Brawl for the NWA Heavyweight Championship, I guarantee you one thing, you're going to be going back to Japan without that belt.
Thank you, Barry Windham, and we'll be right back after these important messages on Worldwide Wrestling.
To another edition of WCW Magazine, I'm Eric Bischoff. A lot of great action still to come, and the Super Brawl 3 Control Center. But a lot of focus now on Cactus Jack, who has always been known as one of the most unpredictable athletes in the sport today. Well, now Cactus Jack has made a transformation into one of the most mysterious. Well, the events that precipitated this change of personality in Cactus Jack goes back to a confrontation with Harley Race, Paul Orndorff, and Big Van Vader. Take a look at this.
Welcome to Thunder Cage, Mr. Wonderful.
You know something? I can't wait to win tonight in Milwaukee. And you know, most of all, it has been Harley Race Duchess Coast to go. And we're going to be yes.
As you can see, Cactus Jack wasn't ready to call it a night yet. He goes after Harley Race, Paul Orndorff, and the world's heavyweight champion with a cold shoulder.
Well, it's one thing you find out, but you don't mess with Cactus Jack. And brother, he's cleaning house right now.
Harley Race, oh, he is getting pummeled with that shovel. Oh, look at this, Orndorff goes out of the ring, and Cactus Jack has just gone berserk.
Well, they've done the right thing to get out of the way, because brother, they're going to get some broken bones there. Cactus keeps belting away with that shovel.
Cactus Jack just dropping athletes right and left.
But the violence didn't end there. At the Clash of the Champions, Thunder Cage, it was Team Vader, consisting of Van Vader, Barry Windham, and Paul Orndorff, taking on Sting and Dustin Rhodes. That is until Cactus Jack literally cut his way into the steel cage with bolt cutters. And the action continued.
There's Cactus Jack! There's Cactus Jack!
What's his purpose here?
Cactus Jack got the bolt!
He's got a bolt cutter. He's unlocking the cage.
Orndorff drives the knees into the face of Dustin Rhodes. Windham around. And Cactus Jack nail Windham. Cactus Jack in there. He's taking off his boot. He's here for revenge. Is it 3-on-3?
This ain't fair, though, Ross. He's got an illegal foreign object in there.
It's a no disqualification street fight. And brother, all six of them now are hooking it up.
And following that confrontation, Cactus Jack said one of the worst things that could possibly happen to him happened that night. He was actually hearing cheers from the fans. Cactus Jack, the man who's always been fueled by the hatred of the fans, is now converting his hatred towards Vader and company into an inspiration. Well, the action continues right after this very brief timeout, so whatever you do, don't leave us now. Back at you after this.
And the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Truth or Consequences, New Mexico, weighing 303 pounds, Cactus Jack. Opponent from Seattle, Washington, 248 pounds, John Peterson.
I don't know bid from Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff.
Well, I'll tell you what, Cactus Jack ain't gonna have to look far, because I've known Mr. Wonderful for many, many years, and Mr. Wonderful has never hid from anybody, Shivani. So Cactus Jack won't have to look far to find Mr. Wonderful.
I would agree with that, Jesse, but if you're Mr. Wonderful, how do you plan an attack against Cactus Jack? He is so unpredictable.
Easy. You go into it like you're going into a street fight. Anything goes, because with Cactus Jack, you got a guy here that don't give a damn about rules.
Right on the head of John Peterson.
Look at the smile on his face. This guy's a Rhodes Scholar, you can tell. Went to school probably with Bill Clinton.
Forearm shot to the head. Head is Steve, catches Jack. Sending Peterson over.
Sending himself over, too. You know, the thing that impresses me about Cactus Jack, he has total disregard for his own body.
That's exactly right.
He don't care. He likes pain. He enjoys it.
He certainly has redefined the term we use, high-risk maneuver. High risk for his opponent and himself as well. Look at Peterson on that concrete floor. What goes to the head again? Double arm, face first DDT. One, two, it's over.
Got him.
Once again, molds over his opponent and has his sights set on Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. Jesse Ventura making his way down to ringside to talk to Cactus Jack. Look at this, hooks both arms, sends him face first. And covers it. Your winner is Cactus Jack. We go down to Jesse Ventura talking with Cactus.
Cactus, I understand your style, but there's something you got to remember. There are rules in pro wrestling. You can't just be running around smacking everybody in the head with a big old coal shovel.
And Jesse, what someone ought to do when Cactus Jack goes out to the ring is go up on that marquee and take the word wrestling down, because it no longer applies. You see, Mr. Wonderful, Van Vader, you did a very dangerous thing. You got inside Cactus Jack's head. And I guarantee you, you're treading in very rough water. Mr. Wonderful, you're about to find out that life is not wonderful anymore. I am not going into this thing blind. Look at me. I realize I'm in a war. I'm going to be prepared to take more punishment than any man ever has. But Ventura, if you could jail a man for the thoughts that go inside his head, then get a rope and hang me, because I'm going after the two of you with very bad intentions. Bang, bang! Bang, bang!
I guess that more or less tells it like it is. We'll be back with WCW Worldwide after these important messages.
Fans, this week's Super Brawl Control Center tries to answer the question, what's the White Castle of Fear, and what about this challenge to Sting at Super Brawl?
Sting accepted an invitation to a party at the White Castle of Fear in the Rocky Mountains.
The party! Let's go!
Roger, we're clear.
This is all about.
The challenge is presented for you to play a game.
Vader challenged me to a game?
I know you like a good time. I know you like challenges.
Could this be some sort of trap?
And I know that you like living on the edge!
I guess I'll find out soon enough.
Come to the White Castle of Fear.
Where is this Castle of Fear, anyway?
And play Vader's game!
Where is this Castle of Fear?
Sting, I've spotted the White Castle.
Familiar about all this.
Vader's here.
Who's the man?
Vader.
Who's the man?
You're the man. Vader.
Stinger.
Vader, nice place you have here. Reminds me of your personality. Cold.
Very funny, Sting.
What's up?
You're here to accept the challenge of Vader. Are you ready to play the game?
All right. So what's the game?
It's over! You know what a strap match is? Well, I'm gonna show you Vader style.
Play the game!
It's the race! The strap! Yeah!
To be continued at WCW Super Brawl 3, Sunday, February 21st, live only on pay-per-view.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is a 4-1 fall. Introducing first, from the state of Euphoria, weighing 341 pounds, Max Payne. His opponent from Rock City, USA, 234 pounds, Scott Allen.
What about the big announcement? White Castle of Fear will be a strap match at Super Brawl, Vader and Sting.
Well, I'll tell you what, Sting's got a lot of guts, Shabani, because You know, by the time it gets to that, he could well be world champion.
Exactly.
To be involved in a strap match with Vader? No, thank you.
Our first look at 340-pound, 6'6", Max Payne.
Love Max's hairdo.
This tremendous athlete we have heard so much about, and his first appearance here on WCW Worldwide at 340. Look how he moves, Jess.
Whoa. Gets high elevation with that big elbow, and I love it because he loves to tell the crowd how good he is.
Takes him down with a submission-type maneuver. It's called the Painkiller. He's got a hook. It's over.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, Max Payne.
It took Max Payne just a few minutes to dispose of Scott Allen with the move he calls the Painkiller. It's a submission hold, Jeff. I made a big next on Worldwide.
You better be ready to do it.
Welcome back to another edition of the WCW Magazine. In case you just joined us, earlier on, Jim Ross in the Super Brawl 3 Control Center announced the match between the world's heavyweight champion Big Van Vader and Sting is a leather strap match. We're going to talk about the implications of this very dangerous match in just a few moments. But right now, let's check in with a man who will be strapped to the 450-pound world's heavyweight champion at Super Brawl 3. Sting is standing by.
Oh, man, the whole wide world knows Van Vader, and I know. I'm so happy you're the world champion, and I get a chance to wrestle you again in a special condition, White Castle. Joined together wrist to wrist with a leather strap. You wanted it that way. I'll give it to you. You want to whip my hide, don't you? Well, I'm going to lug that 450-pound body of yours, if I have to all four turnbuckles, and I'm going to come out on top. And the way I see it, you got more hide to whip than I do.
The obvious question, why would the world's heavyweight champion challenge Sting to a leather strap match? Speculation? It goes back to the King of Cable competition. Vader feels his shoulders were not down for the three count. Well, there will be no three counts. There will be no disqualifications. The object of this match is to drag your opponent from turnbuckle to turnbuckle till you've touched all four corners. No controversy, but a very, very dangerous situation. Again, this match not sanctioned, but it's coming to you at Super Brawl 3 on pay-per-view.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following feature confrontation tag team action set for one fall with TV time remaining. It is a special non-title challenge bout. Introducing first from Cincinnati, Ohio, 226 pounds, Lion Bryan. And from Hollywood, California, 253 pounds, Stunning Steve Austin.
The match that the World Tag Team Champions asked for. They wanted revenge, Jesse. You were there at Clash of the Champions. What happened after the match when they took the belt and nailed Shane Douglas in the head?
I saw it close up, Shabani, close up and personal.
We saw what happened at the Clash of the Champions. What an explosive matchup we have as we go back to the ring.
And ladies and gentlemen, their opponents, they are the unified World Tag Team Champions. Introducing first from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, weighing 239 pounds, Shane Douglas. And from Charlotte, North Carolina, 241 pounds, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
The World Tag Team Champions. This one is not for a title. This one is exclusively here Worldwide, and it's personal.
That's right, and that's what the problem is with the champions. They've allowed it to get personal, Shabani. This is a business. You're a professional athlete. You should never allow it to get personal. And Douglas and Steamboat have allowed that to happen, and I think they're playing right into the hands of Stunning Steve and Flying Brian.
You're going to tell me if you get nailed in the head with a belt, you're not going to take it personally? You're not going to have some emotion?
Shouldn't allow that to happen.
Crying out loud, Jesse. Back they go to a corner.
Oh, and of course, you're the voice of experience, right, Shabani?
Into the midsection.
Because it's happened to you so many times.
Well, I have emotions like anybody else. Right to the jaw now. Austin taking charge on Steamboat in the early moments of this match. Austin and Pillman are the number one contenders of the tag team belts. Steamboat continues to fight back, but Austin shoots him into the left side. Missed an elbow. Missed a clothesline. Steamboat sends him in. Missed a double jump, but that time got him right in the jaw. Wow, what action to begin this match. Double axe handle blow, and Austin going low. Douglas rolls him back in.
Well, Shane Douglas not about to let Stunning Steve get out on the outside for a breather. He was right there, and there's a quick tag. The champion's taking over right here.
On the arm of Austin, and Douglas right up with an arm bar. You saw the top of the program, that interview. Certainly, the motivation is there for Shane Douglas and Ricky Steamboat. They are the champions, but they wanted this match, and they got it. The number one contenders are their opponents.
Well, Shane Douglas is an angry man. Not only angry because he got walloped with the belt and busted open, he's angry because he's a conservative and we got a liberal president.
Right to the chest, forearm, and head first to the neutral corner. Douglas, well, he really took a shot in that turnbuckle, and now look at Pillman. Pillman laying it in, a warning from Randy Anderson.
I'll tell you what, I love Brian Pillman now. Whoa, took a right hand right there, but right to the eyes. You see, he'll do what it takes now to win. That's what he lacked before, but Pillman has it now.
Elbow miss. Douglas back to his feet. Hooks Ryan Bryan. An atomic drop. Steamboat with a chop on the outside. It's going to get down to great teamwork. The team which prevails in this match will have it. Steamboat, snapmare takeover. And right to a neck vice.
Trying to twist Flying Brian's head off. He's got the chin. Referee needs to make sure that the dragon does not have the hair.
Right to the side of the head. That's the first thing Randy Anderson did that time. And now as Brian goes back to a corner.
Look at how smart Pillman is right here. Flying Brian, he's trying to beg off, getting a little time, and then thumbs Steamboat in the eye. Smart move. Big shot. Whoa. Steamboat answers with a chop of his own.
Back and forth they go. Steamboat and shot to the head. And Pillman dangling. He's in trouble. Steamboat again. Side headlock. Flying Brian hits him home to the high side. And Austin waiting on him with a knee. To the back. Through the back suplex.
What? Fortunately for the...
Wait a minute. One, two. Got a two count.
Fortunately for the champions, Douglas and Steamboat, they asked for this match. It's non-title. You know, I'm surprised Stunning Steve and Pillman didn't ask for a title match out of this.
Sends him in. Austin got the tag. Side Salto that time dropped him down and makes a cover. One, two, no shit.
But then again, if Flying Brian and Stunning Steve hurt the dragon and
two
they can't
count.
Defend the title, they could probably get it on a forfeiture then.
I tell you what, Jess, I would love to, one, two, a two count there. I would love to see both teams in a match where the unified world tag team title is on the line. What a match that would be. One, two, once again. Steamboat trying to get back to a vertical base. Austin trying to keep him down. Steamboat is now up. Shoots him to the far side. Side Salto attempt that time. Steamboat counter. Right hand. And again. Steamboat going after Austin. Sends down Pillman. Oh, Austin caught him in midair. He caught him in midair and a spine buster. Nicely executed that time. And makes a tag. Or did he? No, he did not
make a tag. He did not make a tag. I'll tell you what a tremendous, look at this, a double team. Douglas has the referee tied up, and he allows Stunning Steve and Flying Brian to double team in the corner. That's a dumb move on your part to jump into the ring, and I know it's hard not to do in a tag match because you want to get there and help your partner out, but you actually hurt your partner.
Now a tag has been made. Flying Brian sends Steamboat in. Steamboat over the top, sunset flip. Referee makes one, two, two count. Austin had the referee tied up. It was Pillman making the first blow as both men got back up. Here's cover. One, two, got a two count again. cover. One more time. One and two. Handful of trunks, only got a two count.
Hey, he figured they couldn't pin him twice legal. Try the tights and see if he can get away with it.
Chopped at the top of the head. It's staggered, flying right. What a matchup. So much animosity. So many emotions riding on this. Ryan cuts him off with a foot to the midsection, breaks the eyes. And here's Austin again, back in. So it's now the teamwork of Austin and Newman coming through here, Jess.
And I wonder if the champs are happy that they signed for this bout now. Not often the champions have to ask for a match. Usually everybody chases them. I'll bet they wish they hadn't now.
Steamboat trying to get to his corner. You see how close he is. Randy Anderson in great position. Ryan Bryan in. Tag is made. Tag is made. But the referee is not going to allow the tag. He did not see it. And now you see the corner. Using the towel. Using the towel to choke Steamboat.
And that's a correct call by Randy Anderson, the referee. If he did not see the tag, he cannot allow the chain.
He sees that tag, and flying Brian Pillman is back in with a big chop, and Steamboat is in major trouble. Back and forth they go. Reversal, Steamboat.
Oh!
Right in the nose.
He walked into that boot, and there goes flying Brian up to the second rope.
He is ready to end it all right there.
With a nice rolling cradle, but Pillman's legal up to the top rope. Boom! Clotheslines. Douglas from behind rolls him over, hooks the leg. Randy Anderson down. One, two, three. The challengers would have won the title had the title been on the line.
Next week, Sting and Rod Simmons against Van Vader and Paul Orndorff. Our main event. We'll see you at that time.